Ah, Quark. Lots of folks don't remember this show, but based on the number of requests that I get to do something on it, I'd say that there are, at the very least, a handful of people who do. Starring Richard Benjamin, the premise of the show, which was created by Get Smart's Buck Henry, is fairly simple. Benjamin is Adam Quark. He's the captain of a United Galaxy Sanitation Patrol Cruiser, an interstellar garbage scow that goes around collecting space baggies. Of course, along the way, Quark and crew have all sorts of crazy adventures, only semi-related to their primary mission. You know, I'd always felt like Quark was part of the wave of TV science fiction shows that followed George Lucas's original Star Wars film. But in reality, Quark predates Star Wars by about 3 weeks. The first episode of Quark aired in early May 1977, and of course, Star Wars didn't hit theaters until the end of that same month. After the first episode aired, there would be no additional episodes until February of the following year, so it is possible that the executives at NBC were just burning off an unsold pilot with that first broadcast, and then once Star Wars became the worldwide phenomenon that it was, they made the decision to greenlight the show. Now, I don't know if that happened or not. It's just a bit of speculation on my part. So Quark's crew was a pretty interesting cast of characters. You had the two Bettys. One of them was a clone, but neither of them knew which was which. More on them in a moment. You also had Gene, who was a transmute, meaning that he had the chromosomes of both genders. And then there was Ficus, who although he had a human form, was plant-based, which allowed him to regrow body parts if one was lost. He was kinda like this show's Spock. Conrad Janis, the future father of Mindy O'Connell, rounded up the crew as Otto Palindrome, the commander who Quark receives his assignments from. Well, Quark actually got most of his assignments from this guy, the head. But Palindrome served as the intermediary, providing additional context about each crappy assignment given to Quark and his crew. Alright, so I mentioned the Bettys earlier. If I had to say that there was one thing that I remember vividly about Quark, it would have to be them. Played by the Barnstable twins, who had risen to fame primarily as the Doublemint twins during the 70s, the Bettys were the reason that Quark wasn't on Saturday mornings, which I believe had been considered by NBC before opting to give it a primetime evening slot. Both of the Bettys were in love with Quark, but of course, Quark only loved the one that wasn't a clone. Now, if they could only figure out which one was which. Now, there are obvious reasons why I was a fan of the Bettys, but I've got to say that by the time the late 70s rolled around, I was all in on the idea of clones. Any movie, TV, or theatrical that had anything to do with clones, well, I was there. Including its 1977 premiere, Quark ran for 8 brief episodes and was canceled by the network just 2 months after the show began appearing on a weekly basis. It's really too bad because the humor of the show was very reminiscent of Henry's earlier work on Get Smart. One can't help but feel that if the show had been given a chance to build an audience, that it could have been a rating success for NBC. That said, if it had run longer, it would have likely had to have done so without the actor who played Ficus, Richard Kelton. Kelton died of an accidental carbon monoxide poisoning on November 27, 1978, just a few months after the series was canceled. So it feels only right to jump into public service announcement mode here and encourage everyone to make sure that they have a carbon monoxide detector on every floor of their home. They just aren't that much money anymore, usually somewhere between 20 and 30 bucks depending on whether it's also a smoke detector like the one that I've got pictured here. I'll post a link to one that I like on Amazon in the description section of this video. One more thought. I've got to believe that someone involved in the creation and development of Deep Space Nine had a soft spot for our little TV show that we're discussing here today, because that's the name that they bestowed upon that lovable scallywag of a Ferengi traitor that was a semi-regular on that show. I don't know, maybe I'm wrong. After all, a quark is a generic scientific term referring to any of a number of subatomic particles carrying a fractional electrical charge. Still, in my mind, I'd like to think that it was a tip of the hat to a show that was in itself a tip of the hat to the original Star Trek series starring William Shatner, Leonard Nimoy, and DeForest Kelly. All right, one more pick. This time, one without the Bettys. It's kind of hard to find one, but this is a good one. After all, there really is no place like space. All right, now it's your turn. Were you a fan of Quark? Leave your memories in the comments section below, and if you enjoyed the video, please click on the like button and share with your friends and family on Facebook and Twitter. While you're at it, why not subscribe to my little channel? I talk about music, movies, and television, mostly from the 60s, 70s, and 80s. You know, the good stuff. In fact, there are a couple of other really good videos right here that you can click on and enjoy right now. Go ahead, I won't mind. I'm wrapping up here anyway. But most importantly, and as always, thank you so much for watching.